One of the really cool things about the new Divi 3 theme is that you can easily upload page templates to your site. It's a fast way of creating great-looking web pages. There are both paid and free templates available for Divi. I've got a listing of free page templates available on my website, and I'll link to that in the description below. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use those page templates on your own Divi website. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building high-quality websites. If you're new to the Divi theme, I've included a sponsored link to Divi in the description below. You can also learn more about Divi by checking out my reviews of the Divi theme and by heading over to realwebsitehints.com/Divi. This video is part of my complete course for building a website with the Divi theme. My course covers everything from planning your site to the basics of web design. I've broken down my course into actionable steps, and I'll guide you through every step of building your site. What excites me about websites is that anyone can reach out to the world, spread their message, and grow their business, and I want to help you do that. So let's go ahead and get started by learning how to install page templates into the Divi theme. So in this video, we're going to learn how to use one of the powerful features of the Divi theme, and that is the ability to add page templates that you find from another website. It's a quick and easy way to build great-looking pages without having to design them yourself. All you've got to do is just change the content to match your site. So let's do that by finding a page template that we want to use. There's a bunch of different page templates available across the web, and I've put together some free page templates that you can find on my website, and I'll link to that in the description below this video. And so here's the page right here. We've got little thumbnail views of what these page templates looks like. So for this particular one, we're going to create an alternate coming soon page. And so we're going to use one of the coming soon page templates. You can find it right here. All I've got to do is just click on it. And then this takes us to the Elegant Themes website, where they've given us a bunch of free page templates. And we can just scroll down here until we find the download the layout pack button. So we're going to go ahead and download that. And then on our computer here, it's going to give us this file here. This file here, which says Divi 100 coming soon layout packs kit.zip. So we're just going to open that up. And we're going to open up the folder that was inside there. So these .json files have the entire page, images, text, everything, all in one nice, neat package that we can upload to our site. So let's go ahead and do that. So back on the back end of our website here, go over here to Divi, and we're going to scroll down here to where it says Divi Library. Then we're going to click on the Import and Export button up here, and then we want to do Import. We want to choose the file that we want to import. I already have it opened up here to that folder that we just downloaded. So we can just click on the all.json, and that should upload all of the pages that we saw, or we can just click on the Coming Soon pages. So let's go ahead and try the all. Click on Choose. And then we want to click on this big Import Divi Builder Layouts button down here at the bottom of this window. All right, and there we go. Now we can close this. And then we can see all of the layouts here that we've just downloaded. And so to use them, let's go ahead and create a new page. We'll go to Pages, Add New, and we'll give us a name. We call it Coming Soon 2 because I already have a page called Coming Soon. And we're going to use the Divi Builder. And now what we want to do is load from library. So these are the pre-installed page layouts that come with the Divi theme, but we want to use the ones that we just uploaded. So to do that, we click on the Add from Library button up here. And now we can just load the Coming Soon Pages layout kit. So what this has done is it's installed all of the different page layouts that they had all on one page, basically. So what we need to do is just figure out which one we like and then just delete the rest of them. So to do that, we're going to click on Save Draft, and we're going to click on View Page up here at the top. All right, so if I already have one in mind that I want to use. So it's this one right here at the bottom, so the very last one, so it should be easy to find. So go back to Edit Page. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to remove all of these extra sections that we don't need. Just clicking on this down arrow here, which is opening up these sections, and then just clicking the X button to remove it. Okay, now let's do Save Draft. And let's preview that. There we go. So now what I'm going to do is add an image to this side here behind the 68% to get our site going. So to do that, I'm going to go ahead and let's go ahead and just enable the visual builder, and we'll use that. Okay, so what we have here, you can see we've got by the blue indication here, we've got a section, and then inside that section, we've got a row. And this row looks like it's split into two columns. So what we want to do is we want to add behind this first column here, we want to add a image background. So to do that, we click on the settings up here, and then this setting we're going to find under design. And right here you can see it says background image, but we don't actually want to use that because we just want the background image behind one side, just the left side. So we're going to scroll down. And we're going to find here this column one background image. It looks like it was already supposed to have this image in there. Sometimes when you upload a theme template, the images don't get transferred in. I'm not too sure why. And the image is actually on the back end of our website, as we'll see here. You can see all of the different images here. But I wanted to change the image anyways to this truck image. So we're just going to go ahead and select that. And we're going to click Upload Image. Boom, and there you go. Now we can see, great thing about the Divi front-end builders, you can see the change as you made it. It makes it really easy. So go ahead and click check. And then let's go ahead and change the text here. And there we go. Now we've got a custom coming soon page. The only problem with this page is that we have this header area and menu area up here, so we need to adjust that. So to do that, we're just going to make sure we save our page. So click on this little icon up here, which opens up the page menu, and then click Save Draft. And the other great thing that Divi has added, just in case you didn't know this or didn't catch it in the last video, is the ability to do keyboard shortcuts. So if you press the question mark box, it'll pop up all of the different keyboard shortcuts that you can use. So let's go ahead and click on Edit Page now. And to make it so that there's no header or menu bar, what we need to do is go down here to where it says template, and then change the template to blank, and then we can go ahead and publish this page. And now let's view the page and make sure everything's the way we want it to be, so we just click on View Page. And there we go. So now we've got no menu bar up here, just the edit bar because we're logged into the back end of our website. And we quickly and easily created a great looking coming soon splash page for our website using a Divi page template. And it was actually a free template that came from Elegant Themes. And you can find a bunch of free templates just like this one on my website, and I've got a link to that in the description below this video.
I hope that you found this video helpful. If you'd like to learn more about building a great website with a Divi theme, be sure to head over to realwebsitehints.com to learn more about my online course. If you have a question about this video, building websites with a Divi theme, or anything else, leave a comment below. If you want more website building tips, tricks, and reviews, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and visit me at realwebsitehints.com. Thanks for watching.